Follow me, I know you. Tears in your hand, nails in your feet, pierced in your side, I know. Thank you, Lord. Know that how sorrow hallelujah. God is good, and he's good all the time. Amen. I thank him for what he did for me. Amen. Hallelujah. Deliver me, save me from sin. Hallelujah. The Bible says when the fullness of time had come. Amen. He sent forth his son. Amen. To redeem men back to him. And I just want to say thank you. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Men were destroying themselves. Things was chaotic and all messed up. Amen. They didn't know which way was up or down. And I see us going in that same direction right now. Amen. Because he's coming back. Amen. Hallelujah. Will you be ready? Amen. Hallelujah. Bible say hallelujah. We not all of us are going to be asleep now. Amen. Some of us are going to be still here and remain. Amen. And then we're going to be caught up to meet him. Amen. I like the part that we're going to be changed in a moment, in a twinkling of an eye. Amen. I often think about that, Sister Pat. Will I know I'm changed? It's going to be so quick. Will I know it? Amen. Hallelujah. Yes, sir. Amen. We thank God for you today. We ask that you get your Bibles and go to Matthew, the 8th chapter. And we're going to read from Matthew's 8th chapter, 18 through 22. Then we're going to Luke. Amen. I did that because we're talking about a call. Count the cause of discipleship, and then Matthew tells us about two, amen, and then Luke tells us about the third one, three, amen, and that's what we're going to be looking at today, amen. When you have it, say amen, as we count the cause of discipleship, amen, it's on the screen if you don't have it in your hand, amen. And it reads, and when Jesus saw great multitude about him, he gave a command to depart to the other side. Amen. Think about that. Hallelujah. Amen. Jesus, amen, could have soaked up popularity right there. Amen. But he said, let's go to the other side. Amen. And then verse 19 says, then a certain scribe came and said to him, teacher, I will follow you wherever you go. Amen. I want y'all to put a pin in that and remember, amen, the scribe. Amen. And Jesus said to the scribe, foxes have holes and birds of the air have nests, but the Son of Man has nowhere to lay his head. Amen. Hallelujah. Then another of his disciples said to him, Lord, let me first go and bury my father. Amen. But Jesus said to him, follow me and let the dead bury their own dead. Amen. As we go, we look at Luke. Amen. And in Luke, we have 61, and another, amen, also said, Lord, I will follow you, but let me first, amen, remember that thing, first, go and bid them farewell who are at my house. Amen, remember that. But Jesus said to him, no one having put his hand to the plow and looking back is fit for the kingdom of God. Amen. Father God, we thank you once again. Father God, that you have blessed us to come. Father God, to sit under your teaching. Father God, we thank you for the word. It's life changing, Father God. Father God, is a lamp to our feet, a light unto our pathway. Father God, you made the crooked straight, Father God, and the rough places smooth. We just thank you, Father God, for blessing us, Father God, to be in the number, to be in the house of the Lord, where the feast of the Lord is going on. And Father God, we want to say thank you. And Lord, I ask that you strengthen me right now. Father God, as I speak the word that you have placed on my heart. Father God, Kyle, first count the cost to be a disciple. Father God, we thank you. We give you praise in Jesus' name. Amen. What Jesus is saying today to these three men and to us and to the whole world is that God must be first. Amen. Amen. What Jesus said, hallelujah, God is first. Amen. Amen. And he's telling them that God is first in their lives. God is first in our lives. Amen. To be a servant of God, we must put him first. Can I get a witness there? Many people get caught up in the moment. Amen. And make quick decisions. Amen. On impulse. Amen. They get excited. Amen. When things are going. Amen. They see things going on. They get excited. They want to jump, run, and be in the crowd. On impulse. Sometimes we need to slow down. And think about what we are saying. Amen. Say what we mean and mean what we say. Amen. When Jesus came to Peter's house, amen, his mother-in-law was sick. With the Bible say with a fever. Amen. And Jesus just touched her hand. Ain't that something? Amen. And the fever left her. All he did is just touch the hand. When we look at Matthew 16 in this chapter of ours, it says when evening had come, and in other words, a whole lot of people, amen, you know, had heard what Jesus had did and where he was at, and they brought to him many who was demon-possessed, it says, and he cast out the spirit with a word, and heal all who were sick. Amen. He cast out with a word. Amen. If you believe, God can do it. Amen. Can I get a witness today? Amen. And verse 18, read this way in the New Living Translation. When Jesus saw the crowd around him, he instructed his disciples, amen, to cross to the other side of the lake. Amen. As I said, if he wanted to soak up popularity, he could have did it right then. Amen. He could have just stayed right there. Amen. And preached to the ones that were right there. Amen. Just enjoy all the people, all the crowds that were right there. But Jesus said, no, let's go to the other side. Other people need a Savior also. Amen. Amen. He said, I didn't come to be served. And that's what they wanted to do. I didn't come to be served. Amen. I didn't come for you to call me king. He said, but to be a servant, not to be served. And Mark 10:45 says, for even the Son of Man, amen, did not come to be served. Can I get a witness? Amen. But to serve and to give his life a ransom for many. Amen. Amen. Jesus, he came to die that we might live. Jesus had a moving ministry. He didn't stay in one place. Can I get a witness? Amen. And because of all the excitement that was going on that day, Amen. Verse 19 in our text said, then a certain scribe came and said to him, teacher, I will follow you wherever you go. Amen. Can you believe that? Amen. The scribe was expert in legal matters. They were teachers of the law. They were advisors. Amen. Hallelujah. This man was at the top of his career. Man, he comes to Jesus. Amen. And say, I will follow you wherever you go. Man, I don't know what his motive was. The Bible didn't say what his motive was, but we know he was a scribe. Amen. And we know about scribes and Pharisees. Amen. And we know, amen, they tried to destroy Jesus' ministry. But this man, I don't know why he was, amen, wanted to follow Jesus. I think he was caught up in the moment. Amen. And he wanted to go follow Jesus. Amen. Can I get a witness in here today? This man was at the top of his career. Hallelujah. Amen. Maybe he was thinking, if I can get in Jesus, with Jesus, maybe my position would be right under Jesus. Huh? Amen. Because I'm a scribe, I'm an educated man, and these are just fishermen that followed him. Amen. Hallelujah. Officers. Maybe he was thinking, if I can just get with Jesus, amen, hallelujah, I can get ahead of all these other disciples. This man was at the top of his career, self-centered in himself, pledging to follow Jesus. He said, teacher, I will follow you wherever you go. Amen. Now, we know that Jesus don't turn down nobody. He said, whosoever will, let him come. I stand with my arm wide open. Let him come. Jesus don't turn anybody away. And in Revelation 3:20, he said, behold, I stand at the door and knock. Can I get a witness? If anyone hear my voice, amen, and open the door. Amen, you hear his voice and you open the door. He said, I will come in to him and dine with him and he with me. Amen, Jesus wants to be in our lives. Amen, he said he come to the door. The moment you hear his voice, you open the door and let him in. You know, we got to let him in.
Can I get a witness today?
Amen. The answer Jesus gave him challenged him to count the cost of discipleship. Okay. Amen. A life of self-denial. Amen. Verse 20, he said, foxes have holes. Birds of the air has nests, but the Son of Man has nowhere to lay his head. Come on, man. Amen. Hallelujah. You got to think about it if you're going to follow Christ. Can I get a witness today? Amen. If you're going to follow Christ and do the right thing, you got to think about the thing. Amen. Because you know they're going to ridicule you and talk about you. Amen. Like they did Jesus. Amen. We understand that Jesus didn't buy a house when he was here on earth. He wasn't going to be here that long. Can I get a witness? The ministry was only 3 years, 3.5, some say. But that wasn't long. Amen. But we know that Jesus had many houses that he could have stayed in. Like Peter's house. Amen. Like Lazarus, Mary, and Martha's house. Can I get a witness? He had plenty of places that he could stay. Amen. But he didn't own no house. He had none of his own.
Amen. We know that
everything anyway belongs to God.
Can I get a witness?
Yeah. Cattle on the thousand hills belongs to God. Yeah. Amen. He made everything.
Yeah. Yeah. Hallelujah. Can I get a witness? Yeah. Man, what Jesus was saying to the scribe was that if you desire to be my disciple, first count the cost. You can follow me wherever I go. Just count up the cost to be a disciple. This man was excited after seeing all the action that was going on, so he acted on impulse. Can I get a witness?
The second man was a procrastinator. Amen. He was a procrastinator. He wanted to go and bury his father. Not that his father was already dead. Amen. He wanted to follow Jesus, but he wasn't ready to follow him.
Amen. Luke 9:59 says,
he said to Jesus, let
me first go and bury
my father.
Amen. In other words, Lord,
me first
and you
second.
He put his own interests and desires before Christ.
Man, we must choose to put God first in our lives.
Deny yourself, pick up your cross and follow him. Verse 60, Jesus said, let the dead bury their own dead, but you go and preach the kingdom of God.
Amen. That sounds like Jesus don't care about us.
Amen.
He sounds like you don't care about our family. He's cold and insensitive to our feeling. Amen. That's what it sounds like when you read that passage. Amen. But what he is saying, let me first go and bury my father, didn't mean that his father was dead.
Amen. In that culture, they
buried their dead within 2 hours of their death. Amen.
Amen. What he was saying, I have things I need to do.
Things I need to take care of first. And when I'm finished, then I will come and follow you. Man, I want to go home and I got some things to fix up around the house and my father is old. He's not dead yet. But after he died and after I took care of everything, then I'm going to follow you.
Amen. Amen.
He wanted to wait till everything was done.
Amen. Before he followed Jesus. Can I get a witness?
When I'm finished, I'll come back.
Amen.
You got to put God first. You can
just keep on going. He called Jesus Lord, but his own desire he put in front of God.
Amen. If
you acknowledge Jesus as your Lord and Savior, and you are determined to follow him,
is Jesus first and me
second. Amen. Thou shalt have no other God before me. Can I get a witness today?
Amen.
The third man said in Luke 9:61, I will follow you, but let me first go and bid them farewell
who are at my house. Amen.
Let me first go and bid them farewell who is at my house.
Amen.
You know, I got some visitors at my house. Amen. Y'all ever heard people say, I didn't come to church Sunday morning because I had some company at my house. Don't it sound the same? Amen. I didn't come to church today, Pastor, because my cousin was at the house. Amen. My friend visited me from New York. Me first, and God second. That's what most of us think. And that's what the third man said. Let me first go, amen, and bid them farewell who are at my house. Amen. Like the second one, he uttered the same thing. Let me first go and bid them farewell who are at my house. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. We have to put God first in everything that we do. Amen. And if you put God first, amen, he will take care of every one of our needs. Amen. Because we don't know what's going to happen tomorrow. But tomorrow is going to take care of itself. Can I get a witness today? Amen. Jesus tells a story here. Amen. He said, hallelujah. He said that this man who was rich, amen, a rich man, amen, the grounds of a certain rich man yielded many plentiful crops. Amen. And so he, amen, said, amen, I have all this crop and I don't have, amen, place. I don't have no place to put my crop. Can I get a witness? I don't have no space because my barns are already full. Amen. He said, what I'm going to do now? Amen. He said, I'll tell you what I'm going to do. I'm going to tear down the old barns and I'm going to build me bigger barns. Can I get a witness here today? Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. And then he said, amen, I'm going to set back, amen, and take it easy. Amen. I'm going to tear down the little one and bigger barn. Then I'm going to take my ease, sit down and drink and be merry. Amen. Hallelujah. But God said to him, fool. He called him a fool. Amen. Don't you know your life might be required of you? Hallelujah. This day. Amen. Don't you know you might die today? You might die tonight? Amen. In other words, amen. Hallelujah. He should have been thinking about helping someone else. But all he could think about was himself. Amen. He said, hallelujah. Instead of distributing it to people that need it, he said, I'm going to make bigger bonds and then I'm going to sit down. Amen. And take it easy. Amen. Drink my drinks. Amen. But God said, fool. Amen. This night, your soul will be required of you. Then who will those things be which you have provided? Amen. It reminds me of King Solomon. Amen. In the book of Ecclesiastes, he said, all things are vanity. Amen. All things are vanity and vexation of spirit. Amen. And I hear King Solomon say, amen, we work all of our lives. Amen. Hallelujah. We got, hallelujah, all these beautiful things, houses. Amen. We got land and we got our beautiful cars. Amen. And some of us got our 401k. Amen. And we living easy. Amen. Not worrying about a thing. Amen. But I hear Solomon say, amen, hallelujah, you done worked all your life. Amen. And you have produced many things. Amen. Then when you die, amen, and you're going on to heaven or wherever you're going, amen, then the person behind you, amen, maybe your son, amen, and maybe somebody you're going to leave your investment to. Solomon said they're going to come along after you are gone, amen, and then they're going to take what you have built all your life, amen, and squander it, hallelujah, less than a year. Can I get a witness? He said that is vanity and vexation of spirit. Amen. I come to tell you today, amen, you ought to put God first. Whatever you do in your life, put him first. Amen. And God will, amen, take care of you. Beneath his wing, love abides. God will take care of you. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Your life might be required of you. Amen. We build up, amen, mountains of hallelujah of investment. But we don't know what the person coming behind us is going to do with it. Amen. Solomon called it, hallelujah, vexation of vanity and vexation of spirit. Amen. It took a total commitment. Amen. Keep it going. Amen. It takes a total commitment to follow Jesus. Can I get a witness? It may cost you your family members. It may cost you relationship. No one have, Jesus said, put his hand to the plow. And looking back is fit for the kingdom of God. Can I get a witness today? Amen. Philippians, Paul said, one thing I do, forgetting those things, amen, which are behind me. And he say, I'm pressing towards those things, amen, that are before me. Amen. He say, I press towards the mark, amen, of the high prize, which is in Christ Jesus. Amen. I thank the Lord for Jesus Christ. Amen. He said to be my disciples. Amen. You must count up the cost to be a disciple. Amen. You might have to give up some things. Amen. Hallelujah. You might have to give up some of your friends. Amen. But I come to tell you, amen, when you stop doing the things of the world, amen, you're going to lose some friends. Can I get a witness? Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. When I was young and I was smoking reefer, amen, I had a whole lot of friends to the green. Amen. We had a good time. Amen. Hallelujah. Can I get a witness? Amen. But when I put the reefer down, my friends put me down. But I know a friend, amen, to stick closer than a brother. His name is Jesus. Amen. If you try Jesus, whatever you've been doing in your life, amen, hallelujah, you got a crowd around you. But when you decide to put your hand in God's hand, amen, and you leave those things behind, your friends gonna leave too. Amen. When we try to do the right thing, your friends gonna leave. I call them so-called. I want to talk about that next week. So-called friend. Amen. But a true friend will stick closer than a brother. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Ain't God good? Amen. God is good. He's good, y'all. Amen. Think about it. Amen. The same thing. Amen. That was going on then is going on right now. But I come to tell you the blood will never lose its power. It reaches to the highest mountains. It flows to the lowest valley. Amen. The blood that gives me strength from day to day, it will never lose its power. The blood that Jesus shed for me way back on Calvary. The blood that give me strength from service, we normally open the doors of the church. Like my daddy used to church say, the doors of the church are never closed. Amen. It's always open. Amen. We thank God. Amen. That we have a place that we can go anytime. Amen. And say a prayer. Whisper a little prayer. Amen. And talk to God. Amen. It will never lose. Amen. Will everyone for prayer today? Amen. I just want to say we got some good reports today, this morning on our prayer line. Amen. Matanya, who was on the respirator in Atlanta, amen, she is doing better. She is improving every day. Amen. My nephew, some of us know Elder Love. He was in under the knife on last Sunday. Amen. And this morning he was saying he was in a lot of pain. Amen. He had an operation on last week. Amen. And he's healing on today. He asked for prayer. Amen. And my nephew, Reverend McDaniel in Louisiana, was diagnosed with cancer a few weeks ago. This morning he gave a praise report. After only 4 chemo treatments, the doctor said they don't see no cancer nowhere. Amen. Hallelujah. It will never lose its power. Amen. We thank God for that. And I want to thank God for, amen, each and every one of you, those that might be going through whatever. Amen. Keep your trust in God. Amen. Keep believing and trusting in God. Amen. Bless him to take care of your need. And God will take care of your need according to his riches and glory. But first we must believe. Amen. As we pray this morning. Amen. Hallelujah. Touching each other with our spiritual touch. Amen. Seeing each other with our spiritual eyes. And hallelujah. Touching and agreeing upon healing this morning. With our physical mind and our physical touch. Amen. Hallelujah. Can I get a witness today? Amen. Put your hands on this prayer list this morning. In your mind, touch the prayer list with me. That God will heal right now in the name of Jesus. Father God, we thank you now. Father God, for those that are sick, Father God. We praying for Sister Watson today. Father God, we praying that you would heal her body. Father God, thank you for Sister Kennard who is in the building today. Father God, thank you, Father God, for Sister Higlin and Sister Cup, those that might be going through some sickness. Father God, we ask you to touch their body right now. Father God, hallelujah, strengthen their bones right now in the name of Jesus. Father God, we ask you to bless the Jones family. Father God, those, Father God, who have been exposed to COVID-19. Father God, we pray, Father God, that you continue to protect them, Father God. Let no sickness, Father God, come upon them. Father God, we pray this morning for this prayer list that is before me. Father God, we bring this list to you. Father God, for these are your people. Father God, as Isaiah said, Father God, these are your people. Heavenly Father God, so he laid, Father God, the letter on the altar and said, God, these are your people. So, Father God, we lay this prayer list on the altar today. Father God, we ask that you touch them right now in the name of Jesus. We ask for healing right now in the name of Jesus. Father God, we ask if you find anything that shouldn't be, to remove it right now in the name of Jesus. We believe that deliverance in the name of Jesus. We believe that joy in the name of Jesus. Father God, we believe that healing in the name of Jesus. Father God, we believe, Father God, whatever our children might be on, they can be delivered, set free. Father God, we thank you right now. And we count it all done in Jesus' name. And the church said, amen. Let us prepare for our...